Okay, so the pilot for the today's flight is Sonal. So over to you, Sonal.
Thank you, Manbi. Good evening, guests. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm good, thank you. So today we'll be visiting Maldives. Do you know that what is archipelago? So Maldives is an archipelago country. Do you know what's the meaning of archipelago? Archipelago is
I think it is island.
Not icy, it's a group of islands.
Group of islands.
Yes, there are many islands which makes up Maldives. Maldives is not a single island. It's made up of couple of islands.
Couple of islands.
Yes. Moving forward. So, why should we visit Maldives? To enjoy adventurous sports, swim with the friendly sharks, cherish the lovely and friendly Maldivian culture, relax on the private and safe clean beaches, dive into the coral reef, see bioluminescent water under sky. Do you know the meaning of this word, bioluminescent? So,
no.
Okay, so there is an island that is Vadu Island. The beach there, it glows at night. And the secret behind that glow is like because of the microorganism that its name is plankton, which is involved.
I've heard of plankton.
Yes, which is involved behind this mesmerizing shining beach.
Plankton is something that many animals eat, and that's why they come here to the Maldives, especially during the September months when manta rays, especially, they come to feed in huge groups there.
Yes, exactly. So these aquatic microbes are bioluminescent in nature and radiate a vibrant blue light under sea. Were you aware of this fact? The next one is we experience amazing spa there and explore islands. I told you that it is made up of couple of islands, so you can explore islands there. So here you can see below the map of the India and Sri Lanka, it's a small, very small country. We'll see the zoom clear view. So this is Maldives. See, there are a couple of islands. I told you, na?
And it's part of the Arabian Sea.
Yeah. So here you can see the flag of Maldives. The flag of Republic of Maldives is green with red border. That the center bears a vertical white crescent. The closed side of crescent is on the raising side of the flag. It was adopted on 25th of July in 1965. The rectangle represents the boldness of the nation's heroes and their willingness to sacrifice their every drop of blood in defense of their country. The green rectangle in the center symbolizes peace and prosperity. The white crescent moon symbolizes the Islamic faith of the state and authorities. Knowing about the history of the Maldives is intertwined with the history of the broader Indian subcontinent and the surrounding regions, comprising the areas of South Asia and Indian Ocean, and the modern nation consisting of 26 natural atolls comprising 1194 islands. Historically, the Maldives has a strategic importance because of its location on the major marine routes of the Indian Ocean. Maldives' nearest neighbor are Sri Lanka and India, both of which have had cultural and economic ties with Maldives for centuries. Maldives are provided the main source of cowrie shells, then used as a currency throughout Asia and parts of East African coast. Most probably, Maldives were influenced by Kalingas. So they were the explorers from India. Who were the earliest sea traders? And they were traders to Sri Lanka and Maldives from India and were the responsible for the spread of Buddhism. Hence, ancient Hindu culture has an indelible impact on Maldives' local culture. So Maldives gained total independence from the British on 26th of July in 1965. However, the British continued to maintain an air base on the island of Gan in the southernmost atoll until 1976. The British departure in 1976 at the height of the Cold War almost immediately triggered foreign speculation about the future of the air base. Apparently, the Soviet Union made a move to request the use of the base, but the Maldives refused. So actually, Soviet Union thought that this is the best time we can acquire this island for our benefit, but the Maldives refused for its usage. We'll be talking about the capital, the largest city, languages, culture and tradition, president, population and their game. The capital and the largest city of Maldives is Malé. You can see the island here.
Doesn't it have some famous marine life also?
We'll be having, yeah.
What?
It is there. Languages spoken, the language which is spoken in Maldives is Divehi, which is of Indian Arabian Sanskritic origin and therefore closely related to Sinhala, which points at a later influence from the north of the subcontinent. And do you know that most of the culture of Maldives is inspired from India, Sri Lanka, Malaysia, Arab, Persian, Indonesia, and even African from Africa. So a fabulous cultural mix that makes all the richness of the Maldives. So this is the traditional costume of the people living in Maldives. In music and dance, for example, you will be surprised to recognize a purely African rhythm. The Bodabaru, a traditional Maldivian dance, illustrates this perfectly. The language accompanying this dance, followed by the rhythm of the drums, will take you to the East Africa. So the rhythm of this music is somewhat related to the East African music. Let's talk about the government. The Republic of Maldives is an independent island nation. The politics of the Maldives take place in the framework of a presidential representative democratic republic, whereby the president is the head of the government. Executive power is exercised by the government. So there is no monarchy, or it is not headed by a sub-unitary constitution monarchy. It's only a democratic country. So they have president as the head of their state. The current president of Maldives is Ibrahim Mohammed Sulli. The current population of Maldives is 5,49,261, which is quite less. So Maldives has a year-round hot tropical climate. Why they have talked about hot tropical climate, even if this is an island? Do you know why? Have you heard about the equator?
Yes.
Which divides the earth in two equal, right?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Do you know that, sir? Hurricanes come in the equator only. The hurricane.
Were you saying something? I didn't get it.
Yes, ma'am. You know hurricanes?
Yes.
They usually form near the equators only.
Exactly. So, do you know the regions which are near the equator quite hot? Do you know? So the regions which lie near to the equator are quite because the sun's ray falls directly on that region.
It is outside the population.
Come again, Arhan, what were you saying?
What did you say the population?
Population is around 5 lakhs.
9 lakhs? That is
nine.
Too less.
5, not 9, it's 5.
5?
That's meager. Yeah, it's too less.
Because it's mostly surrounded by sea and most of the residents are animals.
Yeah. So Maldives has two distinct and dominating seasons: a dry season, which lies between November to April, punctuated with northeast winter monsoon, and a wet season, which lies between October, associated with southwest monsoon and strong wind. Coming to the animal, aquatic animal, it is yellowfin tuna.
Why out of all did they choose the yellowfin tuna? It makes me wonder.
Why does it seem a little bit different to other fishes? The yellowfin tuna.
Because they could have chosen something even bigger.
And
like a whale
shark.
Like, right.
Two fins over here. Like, over here. Oh, what?
And there's a lot of disturbance.
It's what I want.
Please turn your mic off. So the national bird is white-breasted water hen. Let's talk about the exotic wildlife found in Maldives. The snake. Then we have fruit bats. Rats, birds, turtles, macaws, lizards, whales and dolphins, hammerhead sharks, red shark, reef sharks and beach, manta rays, stingrays and turtle rays. Abhi, you know about these aquatic animals? So this is the sport which is often played in Maldives. You have never heard of. So this is mainly played by women.
Which game?
Bashi. Played on a tennis-like court, a woman is facing backwards to the opposite team, stands with her back to the net and serves a tennis ball over her head backwards. On the other side of the net, a team of girls try to catch the tennis ball. So you can see some images from this game. So this is the national food of Maldives, gula. There are small ball-shaped dumplings that are stuffed with a mixture of tuna, finely chopped onion, grated coconut and chili. Depending on the cook, turmeric, lime juice and chopped curry leaves are added to the mixture. Once ready, the gula are deep fried. Next one, which is a traditional Maldivian snack consisting of stuffed and fried. The dough is made with flour, oil, warm water and salt. While the filling includes smoked tuna, grated coconut, hot peppers, onions, garlic, ginger, minced curry leaves, and lime. Let's talk about the airline industry of Maldives. So, Maldivian is the airline division of Island Aviation Service based in Malay in the Maldives. It is the national airline of the Maldives. It operates international flights in addition to inter-island services. Its main base is Valina International Airport. So, Maldivian Airlines operates fleet size of 23 destinations. These are some images. They have won the National Airline of Maldives received the Airlines Reliability Performance Award in 2019 for outstanding dispatch reliability from Bombardier Incorporation for the 8th time. So we'll see a video here.
And they have not
done the homework.
The wildlife about the place.
The wildlife of Maldives.
Wildlife of Maldives.
It's very interesting.
Yeah, so have you searched about that?
Yeah, one second. Okay.
What was that?
Okay, so is there anyone who wants to share any facts about this country?
I don't even know.
I don't have it.
That's okay. What were you saying, Rohita?
Maldives. I don't even know about Maldives.
That's okay. Maldives, so I hope you all have learned from today's presentation.
Maldives has animals like fruit bats, hammerhead sharks, whales, dolphins, reef sharks, turtles, reef and marine fish, manta rays, eagle rays, skinks, geckos, and many more.
Yes.
They have stingrays and rays. Now that's two things.
Okay, so now we have one video for you. So I'll request my guests to move their mics and enjoy this video.
Yes, ma'am. I heard manta point in there.
Yes.
What is this manta point for? I'm starting to think. Is it?
The Malay is the island.
Excuse me, I'm asking. What is this manta point famous for? Dive site where you can dive with manta rays, it sounds.
Yes.
Actually, I want to do that.
I am going to go there definitely to dive with the rays.
And I was going to definitely see the marine life.
That's really amazing to
me. And go
tomorrow we will be visiting Malaysia.
Malaysia, any tasks?
Yes, so you have
I know what the tasks are.
The famous destinations of Malaysia.
Famous Malaysia is kind of interesting.
Yes.
But I don't think it'll be as exciting as the Maldives.
Well, yeah. Every country has their own excitement, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Maldives is the best country in the world, yeah.
Okay. So,
it is the best island in the world.
Yes, Adika, do you want to say something?
Fiji is also good. Fiji. As island.
Was little used, so can you repeat what is the task?
Okay, so tomorrow we will be visiting Malaysia. So you have to search about the famous destinations in Malaysia you can visit. Okay? So I hope you all have enjoyed today's tour to the Maldives. So tomorrow we will visit Malaysia. So see you at the same time. Bye everyone.
Bye.
Bye. Have a nice day.
Bye,
mom. Have a nice day.
Bye.